Hi, my name is Glenda the Good Witch Sims, and I've been in the field of accessibility since before 2000. Right now, I have the great privilege of being an active member of the Accessibility Guidelines Working Group at the W3C. That's what I do as a volunteer position. My day job is I am the lead of a wonderful group of accessibility experts at DECU. So you may be wondering, what is all this talk about WCAG 2.1? And by the way, what in the world is WCAG? So let me tell you a little bit about it. The Web Content Accessibility Guidelines, also known as WCAG, has been around since May 5th of 1999. Version 1.0 was published on that date many years ago. That first version of the accessibility guidelines was very focused on HTML, and it was a wonderful step forward in making the web and digital technology accessible. It was followed a number of years later, December 11th, 2008 to be exact, with WCAG 2.0. What is the difference between 1.0 and 2.0? Well, 2.0 had learned a lot in those almost 10 years, and technology had advanced a lot as well. And so in 2.0, they wanted to make sure that the Web Content Accessibility Guidelines was technology agnostic. It wasn't just focused on HTML, because HTML is not the only digital asset that we have and use. Whether it's PDF or a text document like Word or Google Doc or a spreadsheet or a presentation or an ebook or a native mobile app, all of these things are digital assets that need to be accessible. So WCAG 2.0 in 2008 broadened the technical footprint of what we were covering. And another key piece of WCAG 2.0 was the four principles that were established. And I love these principles because it's not just a long checklist of things. It's a concept of making digital accessible for people with disabilities. And if you understand the concepts of perceivable, operable, understandable, and robust, you can carry the litmus test to is something accessible around with you in your mind and in your heart from a high level perspective. So perceivable, operable, understandable, and robust were the principles that were clearly delineated in WCAG 2.0. That was a wonderful gift. So here we are, it's 2017, and WCAG 2.0 from December 11th, 2008 is still our measuring stick for accessibility. The web and digital technology has changed a lot in the ensuing years since 2008. So there's been a movement to create a dot release of WCAG, a WCAG 2.1. It's currently being drafted right now. It's available for public review. At a high level, I just want to tell you that WCAG 2.1 is going to add to 2.0. 2.0 was so well written in 2008 that it stood the test of time in that all of the requirements are still very, very valid. So hang on to 2.0 and let's add 2.1 to it. There's a parallel effort to the WCAG 2.1 dot release. The 2.1 dot release is very focused on filling known gaps. And there's another movement called Silver. This is, in my mind, Accessibility Guidelines 3.0. If we could reimagine with everything that we know today, start from scratch on Mars, perhaps, How would we design accessibility guidelines now? That's the silver. So as we look at WCAG, I want you to recognize it is a wonderful standard to use today. And I'm looking forward to, in future installments, telling you more about the upcoming WCAG 2.1 and Silver in more detail.